Hello, Nubis here, and welcome to another Minecraft video. I have a special treat for you. I am joined by Spirion and the Zoro. I'll let them introduce themselves, starting with Spirion's short introduction.
I'm running away. I'm Spirion. As you guys know, I'm in several of Nubis' videos, and today I have arranged to have a modder on the spotlight.
Yeah, right. So I'm the Zoro 266. I'm from Germany, and I started to make this unofficial Logistics Pipes SMP mod 1 month ago with a friend of mine. And yeah, that's where I am now, here with you.
Okay. Now
we got some awesome logistics fun stuff.
Yeah. Now as you notice, this is a SMP version of Logistics Pipes. All right. So don't cream your pants right now, because you know, after the video, you're gonna get a chance to download it. He has added some really neat features, and I have to stress, this is a unofficial build. Unofficial modded version of Logistics Pipes, because Krapht would not release a official version in a decent amount of time. So,
yeah.
Krapht is really, really busy with Buildcraft 3 right now. I think
right
we
now.
All understand.
Yeah, first this, and secondly, he wants to make a SMP version of Logistics Pipes, as far as I know, in Minecraft 1.3, so yeah, the official will come later, but it will take about 1 month from now, and because Minecraft Forge also need to be ported to Minecraft 1.3 first, and all that takes a long time, as you all know.
Yes, it does. Now, as Krapht knows about this mod, and he didn't give his official stamp of approval, but he's not disapproving either. He's given the okay to say to use it. Am I correct in that?
Yeah, you're correct. That's mostly because he's using the Minecraft mod public license, MMPL, and we are free to edit the mod in the way we like, but he already he knows about the mod, of course, and he already told in his IRC chat that he wants to take over a few functions, for example those nifty little signs here, those two things. So that's about him. I think he's a really cool guy, and I hope he will be doing Logistics Pipes. So he goes on with that.
Yeah, and I'm sure he will. Now I don't know a lot about Krapht's background, but I come from a programming's background, and I was told, or I thought I was told, that this logistics system was his very first ever project. Now, if that's true, I don't know your background either, but taking over something like this, you're not really taking over, but actually picking up and doing what you've done with it, was the code messy at all, or was it was it expected from somebody who would just start it crafted?
Well, I have some Java programming skills under 2 years right now, and the code is in some ways a little bit a mess, but as you said, Krapht just started with this mod. I think that could be right, because he already there was a sentence on his the Logistics Pipes thread in Buildcraft forum that said something like that. So, could be right.
Okay, so let's jump into the features that you added. The obvious first feature are these crafting signs right here. There is a crafting sign creator right here.
You can just destroy this very quickly, and you create them with this crafting creator. Yeah, crafting sign creator.
All right, it is made. It's made like shown on my screen right now. Two gold gears up top, a sign in the middle, and a gear down there. Now, is that like a set in stone recipe, or could that change?
Right now, that's not pretended to change. So, I think that will be the recipe for.
Will it ever go to the sets?
It could, yeah. So there could be an additional, recipe with chipsets.
Okay. And this thing is so simple to use. Like, you got your crafting wall here, like normal people have. Just click on the sign there. That's all you have to do. That says empty because it's empty. Down here, you click on it, boom. Boom. There you go. And if you looked at the sign creator down there, it took damage. Now, a few questions I had about the sign creator. How many signs could a sign creator make before it goes poof?
100. Exactly 100. So, another thing I would like to show you is the feature which you just... I just need crafting pipes. It doesn't matter if they are crafting MK2 pipes, so just put here a few pipes in a line. Now I take this you got it. Just give it to me.
Sorry.
Or creator. Okay.
There you go.
And you can click, for example, from this side on the first pipe here. And you don't click from the front on it, but you click on it from this side, and it will create the whole line. So that means you don't have to click every sign, every little pipe on your own, but you can click with one click.
Now, does that use the durability of? Does that use the same durability of making each and every individual sign?
Right.
Okay.
Yeah. Exactly. So just show it to YouTube by doing on that line Spherion just created here.
So far.
So, right, so you just click the end, right?
Stand on the right side where you want to have the signs, yeah, right? You click, it depends on where you click and from which angle you click. So, yeah, that's how they get created.
Right, well,
of course,
these
signs get
cool.
Destroyed automatically. Yeah, of course. So, and next is you can go on. Of course.
All right, and just to clarify a little stuff with these, they're not normal signs. You can't do anything special with these other than what you're seeing with them. Am I correct?
Those are. Not the normal signs as you see, because there are those items or blocks rendered on them, and we made them extra for this purpose. So they were also.
Now I know we're gonna have those.
Still down here, there was a crafting table.
Say what now?
Is that still a crafting table? That bottom one, is that still a crafting table?
Yes.
Okay, these don't date automatically for other people on the server. If you right-click it with your wrench,
not yet.
It'll update
not
correctly.
Yet. Right. For now, the update doesn't work in that way.
Okay.
But we are working on this. So
yes, this and for everybody who is here, it's a very early beta of this mod. So. Especially for SMP. So there's some things that are not going to work as intended, and I'm sure he knows about those features. The one question I had about these was with 1.3 coming out and the ability to stack signs, will there be any like additional to this for, say, you make it and it uses a sign up? Do you know, you kind of know what I'm trying to say?
Yeah, I kind of know. For now this is not planned because we are at 1.3 right now, and it could be an idea, it can be implemented, but for now it's not planned.
Okay, I wasn't really too worried about it because, you know, you can't use them for anything else, they don't drop at the end, so you're not really giving or getting any type of item, because if you break it, it disappears, so, yeah, I wasn't really worried about it. Alright, so, there's a couple other things with these crafting pipes. First, some of you hate it when you have to break your logistics pipes to get to your automatic crafting table. No more. Not only did he add a button to the crafting, logistics crafting pipes, like so, that if there's an open button, you click it, it opens up the automatic crafting table behind. But you don't even have to reach around these signs. You click on a sign and it opens up the crafting pipe, and then you can open that up. So that is a humongous thank you feature by everybody in the logistics pipe community, because that was needed.
No.
Of course,
the search feature of the request pipe was needed,
and we'll get to that. Now, in addition to that, for the crafting pipes, he also introduced a Mark II logistics pipe, which is a little buggy right now, but that's okay. And the feature of the Mark II pipe is it pulls full stacks. Not just one
item. It should.
But right now that feature, as I understand, is not functional.
Not functional, right. Those open buttons also work on this here, furnaces. So that's no problem. If you click on the sign above, click on open, you will get the interface from the furnace. That's also working.
Now, does that work with any machine that is connected to? Like, say, red power furnaces?
Right.
Okay, awesome.
Yeah.
That was really quick.
Okay, so let's go on to, those nifty requester pipes. It's getting pulled forward fast because the iron is compressed into blocks, and those blocks are pretty fast decompressed. So that's why it's getting out so fast.
So you're kind of okay. You're if you're looking at my screen, if you're watching this video, you see this little pipe there, and you're like, "That's a new pipe." Yes, it is. It's a Requester Mark II pipe. What's so special about a Requester Mark II? Oh my god, you don't need a wrench to access it. Alright, so let's go over a few of these features. First of all, you don't see the stats button. Now, we'll get to that. But you see this nifty little search function here. So if I type iron, it will bring up anything dealing with iron. Down here represents stacks. So right now, 11 stacks of iron. No, I'm not, it's not like that, but you see it brings up 12 stacks plus 48. So, I mean, it's really, really good. Everything else works as intended. The stats button, I never really got the stats button to work or working when I tried to use it, but maybe I was doing something, so that's not going to be missed. But I'm just curious, why did you remove it and why wasn't it working? If you can answer those.
Sorry, the stats button. Ah,
yes.
Okay. Yeah, stats were a bit difficult in SMP, and we removed it because I think it wouldn't be zoomed that much. So you have another stats on each player, and transferring all that stats stuff to the client. Would be a lot of network usage, and we didn't want that.
Yeah, I completely understand. Let's go over some recipes real fast. The crafting logistics pipe is very simple. You take the crafting logistics pipe, you put a diamond gear, a gold gear on top of it, or a golden circuit chipset on top of it, and it makes the Mark II version of it. Now, for the requester Mark II is a diamond gear on top of a normal logistics pipe, or a diamond chipset on top of a logistics pipe.
Right.
So very, very simple to make. He's done a very, very good job. I forgot to mention this in the very beginning. He's not doing this by himself. There's another guy called Davboecki. I probably said that name wrong, and I apologize. But together,
no problem.
He and Div is making this. So give a good shout out and a thank you to them too. I will put their IRC channel in the bottom of there. Feel free to go and just give them a thank you. I don't know if they're accepting donations for this or not, but I'm sure that information, when they do, will be in their IRC channel. So if you guys want to contribute or just say a general thanks to them to doing this, because, you know, they're going to make my Minecraft day better because I don't have to do my Let's Plays on a single-player server anymore.
I can finally join you again.
Yeah, I know. Tell me about it. All right, now.
Okay.
Now, a lot of you are saying, all these neat little things are awesome. And Krapht, this being an unofficial build, and Krapht not giving it his official okay stamp of approval, but he's saying okay to the mod. Now, what are going to happen to these cool, nifty little features that are implemented now when he starts doing his official version? From what I was told and understand is he is going to take a look at these new features very in-depth, and if it's something that, and correct me if I'm wrong, if it's something that can be done very easily, he will add them.
Yeah, right. He said he wanted to add those signs, of course, because he liked them as well. So he said that. And that is cool, of course.
And the search feature, man, if he doesn't add that, I will give you his IRC channel so he can get spammed every day about it. Because that has to be added.
Nobius, you can just click on the requester pipe. You can request from whole of the system, and that's working. So, yeah,
in order for this
something
to,
else to
both,
say.
both teleport pipes have to be on the same channel naturally, and they both have to be set to receive true. All
right. Is there anything that we missed
right.
that you want to cover?
Yeah, what's missing is those extractor modules. You didn't explain them. But, yeah, we can just do that, okay?
Oh, extractor mark. Oh, there are multiple
extractor
mods.
The advanced.
I did not even know they were on here.
Yeah. So, there are. Let's just do that from scratch. Oh. There are the advanced extractor modules and the extractor MK2 and MK3. So MK3 does pull out. Yeah, it could be that the stack functionality doesn't work at all, but MK3 should pull out a stack at a time, and MK2 just does what the extractor MK2 does. So we just extended the extractor modules to MK3, and we also added the advanced extractor modules, which can be defined which items should be extracted. So if you open interface of an advanced extractor module,
I've got them all.
You see them all. Don't know where it is.
I'm down here. I'm trying to find somewhere I can. There it goes. All right, so it's just like a normal extractor. Goes, right. Okay.
Get up.
Okay.
Here, look inside this diamond right. Chassis pipe. One with the plus on it.
Right. So if you open this up with your wrench, those are all extra modules, and the advanced extra modules have an item list that can be included or excluded. The normal extractor module can also extract the orientation, of course, but in the advanced extractor there will be the orientation as well. If you just set something up that has an orientation. So I just grab an iron furnace first. Second.
Now, do you have any plans to turn other pipes into modules, like the crafting pipe, making a crafting module?
Well, crafting module are not planned yet, but we'll see. Anyway,
that would be too powerful.
We see just creating this pipe, and I'm just adding here the extractor MK3, and you see you can of course here choose the orientation where it should pull out, so that's the sneaky function, we call that. And the extractor MK3 has now the little sneaky button, so if you click on there you can extract, you can define the orientation as well, same as the normal extractor MK3.
Now these functions are now default in this version of Logistics Pipes, correct?
That's always the of course, but those advanced graphy modules don't have the sneaky button from the beginning, but you need something like furnace or something.
Earlier when I was looking at it, here, let me see this. I'll set the one over here.
Okay. So, yeah, that's it. That's about the extractor modules. And seems good now. Got it?
Alright. Yeah. See, this extractor thing I didn't even know about.
Yeah. That's what I told you. Right now. Okay.
So the advanced ones that aren't to a machine that has orientation don't have a sneaky button. But as soon as they are hooked to a machine, the sneaky button shows up. That's pretty cool.
Yeah.
Alright. Are there the any other, like, are there flexible. Any other functionality to the modules that you added or improved?
Well, we improve the behavior of this chassis pipes in the way that you don't have the exclamation marks buttons anymore if there is no module in it, or if there is a module in it that doesn't have any interface. So Those are a bit, yeah, enhanced, but there's nothing much else. So, yeah, that's all for now. But of course, everyone can go to GitHub and make some issues there and give their own ideas into the mod, and we try what we can do. So we'll definitely make this mod a better one, and maybe Krapht will take some things and implement it in the official one.
Now, while you were in there adding these features, did you optimize his code at all to improve, to just general improvements, or is it mainly just still his code?
It was a bit difficult to dig through his code, but I think we made it, and now we are at this point where we improve his code and also add some improvements to his code. So,
okay,
not anymore his code; it's now also our code.
Okay, if he extended the hand to actually officially work on this with him, would you accept it, or would you just what would go on if he actually did that?
I don't know yet. See, I'm just more not so planned about that, so didn't think about that yet.
Okay,
but if he does it, we'll see.
Okay, and my last question is, what inspired you to take this project on?
Yeah, our own server, we needed logistic pipes, of course, and a month ago we just started, we started earlier, but a month ago we started going SMP with all those mods and set up a server, and the idea was created on a LAN party, and we just set up a server and played the whole night, and then we thought, why not making this server in the internet? Now we got a server in the internet, and we're doing much things there. So it's a bucket server, and it's the only bucket server for now that has all the newest mods in the bucket version, but that's secret. We did that ourselves, and that's mostly no problem.
Okay, well, I am awesome. Completely done with all my questions. Spurion, do you have any that you would like to ask?
I don't think so, really. I'm sure you probably already asked him, you know, where he thinks the mod's headed and what he's got in store for next revision. If he's willing to tell us.
Yeah.
Okay.
But
any final words you would like to add before we conclude this?
Maybe rate and subscribe.
Hey.
Oh, it's not my channel. Nah, it's okay.
We don't normally do that. But I guess we don't. Right? But we figure we'll let you do it this time. Maybe they'll listen to you. I doubt it.
Yeah. Okay. So then, goodbye, YouTube.
All right, yeah, okay.
See you next time.
Goodbye.
All right, guys, see you next time. This has been a special episode with the mod offer of the unofficial build of logistics pipes. And that was just epic. And we'll end it there.